Hi, chums. It's quarter to seven in the morning here, and if I sound a bit tired and groggy, it's because I'm feeling a bit tired and groggy. We're on Maris Pier, and this is one big one, but there's some supplementary information. Number 18 there. Number 18, Maris Pier. One big, and then I filled this right to the top. I didn't norm. I mean, we know the way we normally build the soil up or the compost up as we go. Well, with this one, I didn't. Excuse me a second. With this one, I didn't. I just put the stuff in and let them take their chances. Whatever happened. Now, the one thing here is there's a bulge on the top of this, as you can see. I had to put some extra soil on top of this because a potato was starting to break through, so I put some soil on top. Now, these have been sitting for 3 or 4 weeks now with just in the ground. They couldn't have been growing because I cut the stalks off them a few weeks ago because of blight. So they haven't been doing anything, and this has hardly changed. It's just the same as when I left it. The only difference is that there's weeds on it now. I just want to take those out because I'll be using this compost in my beds again. And I might as well take these little guys out rather than let them develop in the beds and then end up taking out them and all their cousins and brothers and sisters next year. So, what's happening? What's happening is that all the plastering is done in the house and it's all trimming at the moment. Now, yesterday the inside trim was done. What happened was in one of the bedrooms, the guys had to take part of the cornicing off the top of the room because they had to put the thermal boards on and they wanted them to go right to the top. So we went to our local B&Q, which is a huge orange big box store that does everything. Well, it does mostly DIY and tiles and paint and Christmas decorations and gardening stuff and building stuff and washing machines. There's two things like washing machines and that. They're out branching into other stuff, but they're pretty big stores. And we lifted the coving, and what did we find? We found the exact same match as is in the bedroom, which is, I don't know if it's a standard type of coving from years ago, but we couldn't believe it. Exactly the same profile. So we're very happy about that. So then, what do you call it? My mate, he was looking at it and thinking, there's a wee crack in the ceiling. There's a wee bit of paint flaking on the ceiling there. And he just kind of took all the stuff off the ceiling and did everything to leave it perfect for the painter. And the painter arrived last night and said, "What's that stuff there around the curtains and stuff?" And my wife said, "That's painter's mate, or decorator's caulk." And he went, "Right, I thought it was my job." She went, "Yeah, so do we, but this guy's very fussy." So he's doing the painter's work as well to make sure everything's perfect for what he wants, you know. And so it's taking the detail is taking time. Now, I haven't done any videos simply because there's not enough to show you. You've seen the house finished. Now, the next bit was that they did the back of the house was done, and I showed you the scaffold for that. So they did that, and then they did the two sheds, and that was it. And then there's a problem with the dye running down the plinth. So we tried a mix of sand and cement mix and rubbed it on, painted it on, and it seems to be working. So there's a wee experiment going on at the moment with that. But we're now up to the point where we're putting up the fascia boards and gutters. So I'm not going to show you anything until we've got that done, because if I show you the plastering, there's not enough difference then when I show you the fascia and gutter. So we'll wait till that's done and then I'll do another reveal then. But it's just nice not having to worry about doing videos, to tell you the truth. I love doing the videos, but I'm so busy at the moment. I just really haven't got time, you know. And when I'm not working, I'm sleeping. I'm just keeping going as best I can, but it's really knocking me for six this. I'm loving it, but a completely different routine, different type of work and stuff, you know. So as I say, there's what's left of the original. just that little bag and that bit of soggy mess. So it has done its work. It has sacrificed itself for the greater good. So, what was I going to say? Oh yeah, so as I say, no more reveals until such times as the house is basically finished, the outside. The decorator's coming next week. So that means that the week after we'll be able to start getting our stuff back in again. And then I'll get on to a project that I'm really looking forward to, and that is setting up Rosemary's shed for her. Because she has been super patient and waited a long time to get this, so I want to get it done. And there's some scab on the potatoes there. What causes scab? Well, if you have time to listen to 5 million different things that I could tell you, it's all those. Basically, it's to do with anything that can affect a potato, from my reading anyway. A lot of it has to do with irregular watering, and too much watering is the other one, you know. I would be guilty of too much watering, but essentially it's just basically how the changes in water tend to affect the potatoes and cause scab more than anything else. But there are also lots of other reasons for it, and just Google it and you'll see yourself, because I've looked it up, and really at the end of the day, anything at all that causes scab, anything at all that can affect a potato can cause scab. Those are perfect. That's perfectly okay to eat. I just cut that off, and what you see, I'll just take it there, look. Well, dirty, you can see underneath, there's perfect potato underneath, so it's just nothing wrong with it. You're not going to die if you eat a potato that has a bit of scab on it, you know. So just affects the skin, doesn't affect the flesh. So these've all got a wee touch of it, so I might do something I don't normally do and open up a few more bags in the next couple of days to see what happens, and if I need to, I'll get them out of the soil. But look, I'm getting perfect ones again now, so they're not all affected, you know. So I'm not going to worry about it at all. Where are we at then? So as I say, we're still working at the house, and that's just taking up all the time. I really wanted to go to see my cousin up in Fermanagh this weekend, but the builders are coming on Saturday. I think there's three of them coming on Saturday to finish this out and to finish out the fascia boards and soffits and stuff. You see, these guys don't normally do this. These are plasterers, right? But they're, because it's my mate doing it, he's getting his men in to do the other work as well, because you know why these guys can all turn their hands to everything, you know? So they're coming in to do their other work as well for me, to get me finished as a finished project. And when they walk out of here, they want to walk out with everything done. So it means that I'm getting things done that I couldn't do myself, and I'm also getting them done a lot faster than I would ever do them if I did try to do them myself. So that's pleasing me. So having to get up at 7 in the morning and stuff is a small sacrifice for what I'm getting out of this, you know. I had my head right in front of you there, had I? So things are going well, very tired, and what have we got there? I'm going to go for £5.5. I'll go for 5.5, I don't really know. I'll get them into the plastic bag first and see. It's hard to weigh them in the wee bucket, because you're trying to subtract the bucket at the same time. So we're all still alive and happy, so that's the main thing. I'm trying to catch up on the videos, folks. So if you I'm watching lots. I'm not commenting on all the videos, because I'm waiting sometimes to watch two or three and get comment on one to cover them all, you know. So I'm just going to watch them. I watch all my subs videos, but at the moment there's an awful lot of videos getting posted, or else I think I'm spending a lot less time on the computer. Which isn't a bad thing. We'll see what's that now. I'm going to go for £5. See how we get on with £5. But what I did notice there was that all the potatoes were in the top of the bag. They weren't. There were none down near the bottom. So, I don't know if that's significant or not, but I'll not be filling to the top again. I don't like that method. Let's see. Well, you couldn't get it much closer than that. Right, here we go. Hello. Right, what are we on? Well, I think we're in pounds. And we're on pounds. Right, what's that? What's that thing here, dude? I don't know what that is. Right, here we go. Oh, my. There we go, right. 4.75 pounds. So it wasn't far off. So what's that? That's 2.3 kilos about. Oh, no, 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 don't, ah. Oh. Right, we can start again then and go back to kilos, see what they've got in kilos for the metric folks. Oh, hold on, I don't know what it is there now. Right, we'll start, we'll turn it off. Right, that's okay. Right, 4.35 pounds. How'd that change? It doesn't matter. And you know, kilos, that's maybe 2 kilos then. 1.99 kilos. Okay. So there you are. That's all. It'll do all right. For we need some spuds for dinner tonight, you know. And get that way back again. So we need the potatoes for dinner tonight, and Rosemary's making tomato soup out of our tomatoes. It hasn't been a complete disaster. We're getting lots of good ripe tomatoes now, but we're still losing about 30 to 40% maybe, you know. I walked in this morning and there were more on the floor. I'm looking at more lying about the place now, you know. Still haven't worked out what this is. Some people are suggesting blossom end rot, but the problem is it's not in the bottom of the tomato. It's all happening on the top of the tomato. I can just look around here, see if I can find one that's doing that. Look, there's what's happening there. That's the top of the tomato, I'll just wipe that off. And it's all soft and gooey at the top, but look at the bottom. Perfect. You know, you normally get the black spot, but I don't know what's going on. But somebody mentioned botrytis, and I think that's pretty close to what's happening. So whenever I get this stuff cleaned out of the greenhouse, I'm going to give it a real good cleaning down and hopefully knock that in the head. I don't want that in the greenhouse. All right then, so I have to go and get some breakfast in me, and then the boys are arriving at 7:45. I'm going to start again. Okay, all the best now. Bye-bye.